We want to solve the given quadratic equation by completing the square. This video does assume that you're familiar with the basic steps for completing the square outlined here in these five steps, which I did cover in the mini lesson on completing the square. So if you didn't watch that video, you may want to, or at least review these five steps. Going back to our example, this is going to be a little bit more involved because notice how our leading coefficient is equal to 3. The first step here will be to move the constant term to the right side of the equation. So to undo minus 2, we'll add 2 to both sides of the equation. So we'll have 3x squared minus 7x. Now we are going to make this a perfect square trinomial. So we'll have to add a constant here at some point. So let's put plus blank to represent a constant equals, and then on the right side we'll have 2. And then to maintain equality, we'll have to add the same constant on the right. So we do want to make this a perfect square trinomial, but before we do this, we need the leading coefficient here to be equal to 1. So what we'll have to do is divide every term by 3. So we'll divide this by 3, divide this by 3, and divide this by 3. So now we'll have x squared minus 7/3 x plus a constant equals 2/3 plus a constant. Now let's look at our notes down here at the bottom. If we have a quadratic trinomial, as we do here, with a leading coefficient of 1, the constant term needs to be b divided by 2 squared, where b is the coefficient of the x term, in order for this to be a perfect square trinomial. Now remember, dividing by 2 is the same as multiplying by 1/2. So it's probably going to be more convenient if we use 1/2 times b squared, since in this problem, b is the fraction negative 7/3. So let's determine what the constant needs to be. We're going to have 1/2 times negative 7/3, and then we're going to square this. Well, this is going to be negative 7/6 squared, which is going to be equal to 49/36. We need to add 49/36 here to make this a perfect square trinomial. And if we add this to the left side of the equation, we must do the same to the right side. Now we're going to factor this, which will be a perfect square trinomial, and then we'll add these terms on the right. This can be difficult to factor, and that's why I have these extra notes here that show the constant term of the binomial factor would just be b divided by 2, or in our case, 1/2 b. It's the number we had here before we squared. So looking at our work here, the constant term in the binomial factor is going to be negative 7/6, which means this will factor into two binomial factors. The first terms will be x and x, the factors of x squared, and then the factors of 49/36 that add to negative 7/3 are going to be negative 7/6 and negative 7/6. So we'll have minus 7/6 here and minus 7/6 here. Now on the right, in order to add these fractions, we do have to have a common denominator, which would be 36, so we'll multiply this fraction by 12 over 12. So on the right side, we're going to have 24/36 plus 49/36. So we can write this as the quantity x minus 7/6 squared equals, this is going to be 73/36. And now we can undo the squaring and solve for x by taking the square root of both sides of the equation. So we'll take the square root of the left side, the square root of the right side. Remember, we do have to have a plus or minus sign here to obtain all solutions. Now on the left side, we have one factor of x minus 7/6 equals plus or minus. And now to simplify this, remember when we have a fraction underneath the square root, we can square root the numerator and denominator separately. Notice how the denominator simplifies perfectly to 6, and the numerator does not simplify. And now to solve for x, we'll add 7/6 to both sides of the equation, so we would have x equals 7/6 plus or minus square root 73 all over 6. And because the square root 73, we can tell we have two real irrational solutions. Keep in mind we do have two solutions here, one where we add square root 73 over 6 and one where we subtract square root 73 over 6. And sometimes you will see this expressed as a single fraction. Since we do have a common denominator, we could write this as x equals a numerator of 7 plus or minus square root 73 all over our common denominator of 6. Either form is acceptable. Just keep in mind this does represent two solutions. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.